Greetings. In this video, we will be talking about depth of field and how to use it in Daz Studio. Depth of field, also called DOF, is a range of distance that appears sharp. In simple words, it is when you look at something and see it clearly and sharp, but everything around it becomes out of focus, blurred out. It is just our eyes work, we need to concentrate on something and this does blur everything else. If you were to look at most of the renders out there, such as this render of Eve for Alawa 8, you would see the depth of field in action. The main focus point, character is sharp and clear, while everything else, such as background is blurred out. Let's go step by step how to create this ourselves. This is the scene that I am going to use today. It has two simple characters in a free level 19 environment. The male character is closer to us, a female character is a bit further to create distance and a better example. First things first, we need to create a camera. Because depth of field only works with cameras and you can't use it on the perspective view. To add a camera to your scene you need to simply press the Create a New Camera button. Also, you can make it copy the position of your current perspective view, for an easier positioning. I already have my camera created and positioned properly. It is pointed at the characters and captures them really well. If I turn on the thirds guide, you will see that they are positioned right on the intersections. It is where most attention is pointed usually. Let's see how this looks rendered. I could render this scene out, but you should be able to observe all the main things even in the iRay viewport. So we can see that there is absolutely no doof on the scene. Everything is equally sharp, nothing is blurred even a little. Looks very unnatural, because our eyes can't see everything equally sharp as this. By default depth of field is turned off in Daz Studio, so we need to turn it on. For this, open the cameras tab. It is usually located here on the right side, near the bottom. If you can't find it, just open it by following the window, panes tabs, cameras. In this window, we are interested in the camera section. Here we have the depth of field settings that is turned off. Click on it to turn it on. And let's render the image this time to see what exactly did this setting change. On the render, we can see that the female figure is quite sharp and we see it clearly. While both the background and male figures are blurred. Just turning on the depth of field is not enough, we need to set it up properly. On the scene, if you would go into the perspective view and point it, so you could see the cameras from the side. You will see that some new gizmo has appeared on the camera object, these two planes. When I turn off and on doof, they appear and disappear. They show us the depth of field range. So everything between these two planes would be in focus. Such as the female figure. And everything that is out of their range, would be out of focus. Like the male mode. Exactly this we saw on the render with the female figure being sharp and male being blurred out. We can control this range by changing the settings from the camera's window. Namely, the focal distance setting moves planes further or closer to the camera. You may notice that when planes move, the distance between them changes too. The green and red cross is the focal point, the very middle of the depth of field range that would be the sharpest. F/stop changes the distance between the planes, which allows for a very shallow or wide depth of field. So using these two options we can control exactly which parts of the image would be in focus. I want the male figure to be seen sharp this time and everything else is out of focus. So you can see that the figure is exactly between two planes and the focal point is in the middle too. When rendered, this scene looks exactly as was expected. The model in the foreground is perfectly sharp and visible, while the figure in the back is a bit blurred. With the background being far from the focal point, it was the most out of focus. To show more examples, let's now change things up and make female figure to be in focus with a very shallow depth of field. So I change the focal distance to place the focal point right on the figure. And correct f-stop to some value that is very low, to receive the effect of a very shallow doof. Render perfectly shows the result. Everything except the female figure is very out of focus, with absolutely no details seen. The doof so shallow that even the female hand and legs are a bit blurry. Let's analyze another situation, when you want to have a big range depth of field. So on this scene, it is when both characters are in focus, but the background would be a bit blurred. For this situation, I move the focal point to be somewhere between two characters. And change f-stop, so that both of them would be between two planes. A few small corrections and it is ready to be rendered. The result speaks for itself, both characters are visible and are in focus, while the background is out of focus and blurred. Exactly as we planned. As was mentioned before, depth of field is very important and widely used everywhere. You can just visit the Daz3D.com shop and it for yourself here. For example, let's take one of the newest figures, Jacqueline 8.1. Notice how all renders have a depth of field on them in some regard. Parts of the scene that are meant to be the main viewing point, as the figures, are very sharp. Everything else is less sharp, the further it goes. Like here we can see that the very shallow doof is used, even things that are close to the character, such as wheel and hands are out of focus. On the Daz3D.com shop, you can also find other products that will help you with depth of field scenes. Such as HDRI sets like Ultra HD iRay HDRI with doof, Meadows. The catch here is that this HDRI is designed to be used with doof. Or another even more prominent example, After Midnight 28 HDRIs and lights. The catch here is that these HDR images already have depth of field built into them. The ground is sharp and backgrounds are blurred. So these scenes can be rendered without using the Daz Studio doof at all. To learn more about doof, you should check out our Daz3D Depth of Field, How to Use It article. Or the Daz3D Portrait tutorial that explains how to use doof and not only it to create a proper portrait render. These and more articles can be found on our website, renderguide.com. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to get more inspiration.